Sure.
Grizzly with a 6-2 lead on home ice tonight. Now, Adams to Curry. Backdoor play. Here's a chance. They score! McBride from Adams and Curry. It's 7-2.
McBride. Winners for Victoria.
Full pickup now. 4-on-2 rush here for the Grizz. Pickup wrist shot. Rebound in front. Here's a chance. Scores! Sean McBride! And here come the Teddy Bears! And we'll settle things down tonight as Sean McBride picks up a loose rebound off the glove hand of goaltender Tanner Kovac on a long shot from the line, and the Grizzlies score on the power play. So he checked that they score even straight into this pearl. Here's the official call on the goal.
Scored by number 7.
Point for Meek. His shot deflected.
He scored!
The Grizzlies! 1-5. Neutral zone hockey. Massey, McBride, and pickup. Pickup from a sharp angle. Trying to get around the defense, but along the near side. Massey and McBride. Bouncing puck pickup. Pickup, sharp angle. Drop out, McBride. He scores!
The All-Victoria! McBride in overtime, we got a hero. See you on Friday night. Paul Rivers coming to town. Kick up with a great drop pass. McBride scores. Grizzlies in overtime. They win 5-4 on their 61st.
Over to pick up by the goal line. Centering pass, and Forster tried to bat it. There's another centering pass. They score. Brett Gruber.
What a bunch of great passes in a row. Started with pickup down by the Wilson sign at the Zamboni door. Back across, and it was Gruber was the final, was it?
Here's a feed. McDonald. He scores. It all started by Dixon to McBride. Back.
Dixon shot deflected in front. McBride two in a row. He scores. Top corner, he deflected it. The rebound, that could be the end of a cashew. It's 5-2 for the Grizz as Dixon threw it at the net. McBride got his own rebound off his own deflection.
In the new year, doesn't feel like a Friday night. It kind of feels like a Monday night in a weird way. Here's Massey to McBride. Nice pass in front. Wow, a rocket by Forster.
Tic-tac-toe. 2015 starts off with a great shot.
We are having some serious issues on our audio, that's for sure.
Opening faceoff brought to you by West Shore Center for Learning and Training and Fix Auto. Grizzlies move our broadcast right to left. There's a centering feed, McBride to McDonald, and they score early. Last night, 12 seconds in. Tonight, 11 seconds in. McDonald with his third point in two nights, his second goal in two nights. McBride on the assist for sure. Maybe Massey as well. What a start.
Right in.
Far side of the net and just barely tuck it under the pad.
We're going to review this. The only reason I hesitated there for a moment, if you don't normally see a referee for both.
Hamlock gloving it out of the air, holding it in, but out of the zone. Here's McBride, cross ice feed, 2-on-1 and a goal. McBride to John O'May, number 12.
By AIC. Melberg moves behind the main net. Melberg outside, turns and shoots. Tip, save, rebound, score. And that is Sean McBride tapping home the rebound. And so AIC on the board, and that ties it up 1-1.
Far side, McBride. McBride looking to dish it off. Dishes it off. Patrick! Save, rebound, he scores, and AIC takes it in overtime.
Testing has showed solid improvement in both areas, and that's only good news for Penn State. Here looking for the late chance, shorthanded, and they find it. Might have deflected off of McBride in front. He was set up by Reinhardt. Shorthanded goal. And this is disbelief from Nittany Lion fans.
Well, this may fall into the review category depending upon the contact with Peyton Jones. Now, what causes the puck to go in? If it's the player sliding in, if it's Big McBride sliding into netminder,
he's pushed in by
Peyton
Byron.
Jones, yeah. But certainly you can argue the contact denies Peyton Jones the ability to play his position and stop the puck. But to your point, if Brandon Biro is the player initiating the contact, it's clear in Peyton Jones' mind what happened, isn't it? It can be a very demonstrative
power play, but AIC got it back. Beautiful puck protection. That went off pass though. By Sean McBride and collect.
McBride coming in. Save there. Actually went in. The initial stop was made and it slid in there. 7-2.
The zone on the far side, hash marks and stops back for Elmer. Gustafson tries to break it up, but it's McBride who intercepts. 2-on-1 the other way, shorthanded. McBride for Jekyll, back for McBride, back to Jekyll, and a save that hits the side of the net. And now it caroms in! A shorthanded goal for Alex Jekyll with 5:57 left in the second period. It got through the wickets of Lecouvé.
The Admirals, and here comes Pavel Rozniuk stopping at the circle, finding McBride to Phillips. Fakes and scores! How about it? Zach Phillips, what do you say? His third goal of the season, and just as the Steelheads tied this game up, the Admirals get the lead right back, courtesy of Zach Phillips on a backhander.
That's a huge answer by Phillips. That's a little bit of the flash of brilliance that we talked about in previous.
Pretty much par for the course. Here's Grott coming over the line. Long shot off the glove of DiPietro. Look out, they score! DiPietro had a off his glove. He lost sight of the puck shot.
He's headed to Ontario, California after this game to represent the Pack and Lee All-Star Classic. Grott scores! Grott takes a feed with the left wing corner.
Matthews has scored his 42nd of the year. More scores in a moment. Hopper out in front, and it bounces off the glass back in front and a score.